With us just before the weekend to speak about the company's Amersfoort gas to power plant is Kinetiko CEO Nick de Blocq. Nick, how are you doing?
It's very early in a wet and cold Cape Town, but very pleased to meet you, Elisha.
Well, we're so glad to have you here, Nick, to speak a little bit about your plans. Now, you're about to kick off your gas to power project here in South Africa. What's led up to this milestone?
Firstly, I think let me manage expectations a little and correct the impression that this is all happening tomorrow. There's still a lot of ground to cover, and we're doing this in a staged approach, starting with some small proof of concept exercises and getting larger as we move forward, if that makes sense. But there's still work to do in that regard, but it is definitely on the way. All these wheels are turning. To answer your question, what has led us here is many years of very focused and expensive exploration activity, whereby we've successfully proven the geological ability to support various production pillars that we have conceptually planned. And now naturally we need to take the next step of a natural evolution into production in a scalable way, while remaining essentially an exploration company. So there's still a hang of a lot of work to do.
Certainly. And this sort of, I guess, moving forward comes not too long after you drilled your three Korhaan wells. Can you tell us a little bit more about this program?
Yes, indeed. So a while ago, the Amersfoort area of Mpumalanga was identified as holding a huge potential for long-term gas production. And after a decade ago, a success story when we drilled a couple of test wells in that area, it made sense to expand our understanding of that microgeology of the area and drill a few more wells to create a cluster from which we could deliver to an infield gas to power plant. And all three wells cut gas, continuing our current 100% success rate. All of our 30 boreholes so far have hit gassy sandstones. We've got quite a good coconut shy going on. One of them had a disappointing response though, and may need some slant drilling to fix the problem, but the other two look very good as producers to add to the existing two wells in support of the gas to power.
Now, Nick, I also understand that you've engaged an independent consultant who will go on to support your maiden gas reserves here at Amersfoort. Now, how does this all lead into your forward plans?
Yeah, look, isn't it always very exciting when you get your maiden reserves on the table? We've already have great resource reports indicating close to 5 TCF of contingent gas. And now as we take a step towards some sort of a eventual beneficiation, it made sense to get an initial reserve study done, which can be updated as we move into other areas and add further pillars of production to our mix. And Sproule, of course, is a very globally respected and recognized service supplier for this kind of thing.
Now, Nick, what I'm hearing in all of this is it is still early days as you get ready for this gas to power project. I want to take a step back now and look at the big picture and why a project like this is so significant in a region like energy-hungry South Africa.
Oh, yeah, look, South Africa has never needed an injection of energy solutions as much as it does today. We have a rather destructive mix of a lack of power on the one hand and an over-reliance on coal, diesel, heavy fuel oils on the other, you know, which don't sit very well within any environmental plan of improvement. We are offering something much cleaner, the much, much better calorific value to help the country move its thermal industries and power generation away from the let's face it, the dirtier particulate producing methodologies of yesterday. So, you know, it's essentially a green ticket that we're on. We're trying to help clean up the act.
So as the company embarks on this next chapter, Nick, what's remaining for the end of 2022?
Oh, yeah, no, we're still active. We're currently doing some responsible abandonment work on some older wells, core holes that we drilled in the past. And this will be followed by another core hole drilling program right across all three of our active blocks. As I said earlier, we remain an exploration company in essence, but we need to get a better understanding of the geology of the areas where we only have aeromag surveys, gravitometry to work from. And this is the basis, of course, for further well drilling as we move steadily and surely into an era of adding piecemeal solutions to the energy needs of this country. So we're going to be starting with the core well very close to the Majuba Power Station in the middle of our Block 271, followed by at least three wells in each of Blocks 270 and 272. And that should see us nicely through to the end of this year.
Well, we look forward to the next couple of updates from you and the team at Kinetiko. Thank you for your time, Nick.
I look forward to that, Elisha. Thank you so much.